Good morning. Good morning. We are about to begin the pep rally. We're going to need everybody to take a seat, find a seat, except for the cheerleaders, of course. If you are standing, please take a seat, get comfortable. We have plenty of chairs. Okay, we're just about ready. There's a lot of excitement in the air, as there should be, but we're going to proceed decently and in order.
This one is dedicated for all the workers that work 9 to 5. You wanna party, yeah. Hey, it's Friday, let's party tonight. Party, baby, it's Friday, Friday. Yes, it is. Gonna party, and I'm gonna party and get my groove on. Get my groove on. It's Friday, it's Friday, baby. Beat the baby, and I'm gonna party till the break. Yes, I am, yes, I am. I did my work this week. Woo! And baby, I just got paid. Gonna go buy me a fresh pair of gaiters with some of this money that I made. Man, waiters on the radio singing about the whiskey. Stove to get me a bottle so I can be ready, yeah, to get my groove on the dance floor. Baby, baby, it's Friday, it's Friday, Friday, baby, I'm gonna party, party, and get my groove on, get my groove on. Stepped in the club, looking candy and clean. Ooh-wee. I see a woman just for me. I'm gonna say, baby, do me the honor. Would you please have this dance with me?
Thank you so much.
'Cause it's Friday and I'm feeling good. And I'm gonna party. The lights come on, and I'ma do the electric slide to Johnny Taylor. Slide on, baby, baby, it's Friday, Friday, baby, and I'm gonna party, party, get my groove on, get my groove on. Can you play Motel Leather? Oh yeah. So I can ask this lady to please take me. I've been at work all week and I deserve to come out and have a good time. I've been spending my money on everybody else. Tonight I'm gonna spend every dime. 'Cause it's Friday, it's Friday, yes it is. Gonna get my groove on, I'm gonna party and get my groove on, get my groove on. Hey. It's Friday, Friday, baby, oh, oh. And I'm gonna party till the break of dawn, break, the break of dawn.
Okay, right now we're going to bring the team in. Okay, at this time we're going to bring the team in, so quiet down, get ready.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
It's game day. Definitely a sight for sore eyes. I ain't seen y'all in about 2 weeks. And I will tell you, I missed y'all. It's always something good going on here. And today we're going to deal with the great. I appreciate everybody that showed up to capture what we do on a regular basis. The education process is ugly, but it definitely is one that must be done. And it's most appreciative. Before we move any further, we're going to tell everybody in the audience to sit up straight and to be a good audience. And if you're a visitor, make sure you cut your phone off And for those of you who don't know me, I hear and I see everything, so watch your mouth. Please don't make me call you from the podium. And let's enjoy this thing. Before we go any further, we're going to open up with a prayer by our very own Pastor Ware from the historic Greater Friendship Baptist Church. Let's give him a round of applause.
What's up? What's up? Y'all ready for the game? This is not a pep rally. I said, are y'all ready for the game? Let's look to the Lord so that we can really get it together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this another rich and wonderful opportunity to bow our heads before you. Our prayer, God, is that you cover our team. Every single person on the team, God, cover them from the top of their head to the bottom of their feet. May they have fun. May they learn. But more than anything, may they be victorious. May they win every single down. We pray for all of the students here. We pray for all of the Glenville students here and the cheerleaders. We pray for the parents and the teachers, God, that you watch over us. We thank you for this another rich and wonderful opportunity to lift up and magnify your name. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Y'all gotta clap for Jesus better than that. Come on. There we go.
Before we go any further, High Tech needs to be dismissed now. High Tech needs to be dismissed now. So let's do that quietly. They don't want to leave. Well, we'll deal with that in the end. We'll take care of that in the end. Next on the list. Many times, especially as men, we get carried away in our accolades, our goals, our accomplishments, and we forget to acknowledge the women that make everything go. So before I go any further, I want to make sure that we acknowledge Jeanette Ginn is in the house. Let's give her a round of applause. Couple things they want me to do before I get up out your way. First and foremost, let's make sure that we understand the day-to-day that is here at Ginn Academy. Your senior picture day, Wednesday, December 6th at 8:30. Please see Ms. Overton on Monday for important information before you take your pictures. Once again, that is business of importance. See Ms. Overton on Monday before we go towards Wednesday. Please understand that the fan bus is filling up quickly. If you plan on being on the fan bus, you need to turn your slips in right away. You need to turn your fan bus slips in right away to your youth support or to the office. Today, once again, the bus is going quickly. Don't miss your opportunity to be a part of history. Lastly, the Glenville Tarblooders will play Kettering Altar on tomorrow, Saturday, December 2nd, at Canton Stadium at 7:30 p.m. It is assumed, I haven't talked to anyone, but we should be still getting our tickets from OHSAA. You cannot pay at the door. Don't beg, borrow, and steal to get to Canton and then think you're going to pay at the door. Get your ticket in advance so that you can get down there and enjoy yourselves. Last part that I want to add, just from, again, Glenville point of view, make sure that you don't only represent yourself. You represent us. You represent your mom and them. But you also represent mankind.
go down there, act like you got some sense. We do not need to be on the national news for the wrong thing. If anything, make them realize how well you behave and how good we do things right here in the inner city of Cleveland. And let's represent again Glenville to the fullest. With that being said, I'm gonna get out your way and I'm gonna turn it right on over to the cheerleaders. Let's give them a round of applause.
Yeah!
Hello, hello, hello. Let's give them another round of applause. Again, what a display of the excellence that is within our neighborhood. Glenville is represented very well, whether it is in athletics, academics, and even in cheerleading. Once again, give them another round of applause. So as we move further along, I'll turn this program over to our principal, Mr. Damon Holmes, for his opening remarks. Let's give him a round of applause.
Good morning. I think I'd be remiss if I didn't acknowledge the fact that our cheerleaders are defending state champions. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. You guys put on a great show. And again, a lot of times we take time to look at this and we see events like this and we have what people will call haters who say, why do we spend so much time celebrating this? It's football, it's a game, it's that, why do it? But this is larger than just a game, it's larger than just Glenville. This is something to celebrate for the entire city. This is for Cleveland. This isn't just for Glenville, this isn't just for the Northeast Side, this is for the city of Cleveland. Something that doesn't happen that often. Something when you turn on the news, we hear nothing but bleak stories. And this gives us an opportunity to celebrate hope of all the wonderful and great things that can come through here. And when it's collective like this, like a team, it gives us a reason to celebrate. But what I would like, gentlemen, is for us to understand that great things happen every day. We have reason to have hope and celebrate every day. Braylon Brooks is over there and has been accepted to 5 schools. Reason to clap it up. Rain has been accepted to Jackson State and other schools. Clap it up. Glenn Wright, same thing. And many others. We have juniors that are gonna do great things, sophomores are gonna do great things, freshmen that are gonna do great things, and we have a whole school of Glenville that are sisters, brothers' school that we love so much that are going on to do great things throughout this city. But Saturday gives us an opportunity to celebrate an entire team that is transforming what we believe about this city, what we believe about you, and what we believe about all of you and all the things that we can achieve. So to the football team whom we love and who represent us so well, just go out and win, fellas. Thank you. Coming to the mic now, the head of athletics for the whole city, we give it to Ms. Desiree Powell.
Good morning, everyone. I'm not going to be before you long, but I did want to share some words to the football team as well as to all the students, both from Glenville and Ginn. People don't just wake up one morning and become successful. People decide their futures. They decide their habits, and their habits determine their success. And that's by John Maxwell. So the habits that you chose all last year got you to the championship last year. And the habits that you've chosen thus far have gotten you to potentially get a second championship. And it was all because of the work that you put in with your habits to get this far. But the habits aren't just for football. The habits are for everyone in this room so that they can succeed in life. So it's not just a game, but it's also life. And the only other thing that I want to leave with you is that everyone in the city of Cleveland is your 12th man. So know that we are all behind you and giving you that extra effort as you go down, as you hold them, and as you keep going down for all your first downs and the touchdowns. So congratulations, and we are right behind you.
Everyone stand. Everyone, everyone, everyone. And it's not that
I had to make you stand. It's not that I didn't think that you would have stood on your own, but my main focus is to make sure that we give this man the credit that he deserves. It's a whole lot going on that y'all don't know about. Whole lot of arrows that people got to take to make this thing go. And while some of you may not ever know, personally, I know. And I'm grateful. And I'm bringing to the podium right now the head football coach and the founder of the Ginn Academy, Ted Ginn Sr.
Good morning. Before I speak, I got two captains here, and they're going to speak to you for a minute, okay?
All right, G, I want this message to go to you because you have been with me all my life as far as I was a baby, saying to you, Ms. Ginn, and I thank y'all for everything because you know all the adversity I've been through, never had an injury. I don't want to cry on the mic, but you know what I've been through is sophomore year, tearing my hamstring, coming back the next year, tearing it out again. Before the season started, fracturing the elbow. Came back, separated another shoulder, came back again, dislocated my shoulder again. Now in January, you know I got to get surgery. And a lot of y'all didn't know that. And I thank you for sticking with me through all my career because without you, I don't know what I'd have been today. And thank you for developing me to the man I'm becoming today. Because you taught me how to always fight through adversity when you're back against the wall. And I thank you for everything. Same for you, Mrs. Ginn. As far as the Glenville football team, I do thank y'all for everything because y'all never gave up on me. When my back was against the wall, y'all always encouraged me to come back, come to practice, even when I wasn't playing. This is going to be my last time playing with a lot of y'all. And I'm going to school next year with one of my teammates, Mario. I went. You know I'm going early, bro. Oh, you come down there. You know what we got to do. Because Arville right now, he's down there. He said it's hard, but they expect a different mentality out of us. Thank you for all the Glenville captains, Fred, Jermaine, D, because y'all have been with me all my life. Glenville football team, I thank y'all for everything. Let's go win another state title.
First, I want to thank God. I want to thank my mom. She over there. I want to thank my other father figure, Coach Ginn, other father figure, Coach Coffee. I want to thank everybody that's in the building for coming out to support us. I also want to talk about being two back-to-back state championship. So we went through a lot as a football team last year and this year. As me playing injured, I've been playing through so many injuries. Coach Ginn told me to keep playing through it. Be a dog. All the stories that he told us about all the alumni and stuff, I just wanted to make history, and I did it. I did it twice, and we're going to keep making history. All the young guys, I'm going to open doors for y'all, and that's what I'm supposed to do as a senior. And I just want to thank everybody that's in the building, the staff, from Coach Ginn, the coaches, to the parents, for getting y'all kids here every day, for being a team, feeding them every day. Parents don't get enough love, but I'm gonna show y'all some love. I appreciate y'all. I would like to thank the students from Glenville, Ginn Academy. Thank y'all for letting this happen. Some of y'all could have walked out or whatever, not supporting us, not even came today. But I appreciate y'all too. Last but not least, Coach Ginn, I appreciate you and everything you did for me. Me growing up as a young man, never letting go by me telling me the right thing to do and just letting me grow up and pulling with all my stuff that I had to do and my attitude and everything, you let me grow. And I appreciate you for that.
Well, once again, good morning. To the athletic department, Ms. Powell and all the staff from down there, we appreciate you all being here this morning. To all the staff at Ginn Academy, Glenville High School, and all the support you give us over the year and over the years for some of you. Let's give them a round of applause. And to the parents that's here, you know, we appreciate you entrusting your child with us. You know, even the Ginn Academy kids, the Glenville kids, you know, the football team. Just believing in an educational system that can help you raise your child to be productive in the world. You know, we want to appreciate the parents. So let's give them a round of applause. Well, you know, when you're trying to do something different, now I tell the kids all the time, it takes courage to be different. It takes a sacrifice to be successful and to be great. We just don't come here every day trying to just get by and different things like that. It's a purpose of being a Glenville Tarblooder, a Ginn man, and a Glenville football team. You know, it seems like we just here for a game, but we're not. We're the trailblazers for life. We're the example of hope for the next child. We're the leaders and the example of what it's supposed to look like in the inner city of Cleveland. You know, we talk about winning state titles, we talk about all that, but it's really more than that. It's an opportunity to engage with children, that you can set a table for them, that you can give them direction, you can help them live and help them guide them through the world. This is real ugly today. So we are needed so much in this room as educators, as parents, as leaders for the children. These are God's kids. And this is just a vehicle that we use to be able to engage and teach. Let's take a look around. You hear the cry. You hear the cry of the community. You hear the cry of the children. You see that. But having a football team is an opportunity to engage with them, to try to keep all the noise away and guide them into how they can live in corporate America. That's our job. Being a head coach, being a teacher or principal or anybody that's in position for God's children is a dangerous game if your heart is not in it. It's dangerous. And it's a judgment day for that. If you in it and you don't love it. We're not here just for a championship. Look around. Look at us. They say we can't do this. We can't have 400 kids, a staff that can be in order and have a purpose of life. That's all this is. When I look at the football team, this is the last go-round for some of the seniors. When you think back to the pandemic, this group of seniors didn't play football. It was the pandemic. The next year, they played ball. So they missed a year out of their 4 years. So that's real special because they are winning against all odds because they say we can't do it. Winning a football title last year was the first team in Cleveland, an inner city school, to win a state title in 100 years. Glenville High School did that. That was real special. But this year, it's going to be even better, even bigger, because in the history, and I'm probably talking about across the country, you never had a inner city school to repeat a state title. I think over the 100 years, it's only maybe three high schools from the inner city that ever won a state title on all levels in the state of Ohio. And that's probably was Buchtel, Trotwood, and Glenville. So now we will be the only team ever to go back to back from an inner city school or a public school that's all African American. The odds are totally against the inner city schools. The tournament is not set for us. But we showing the world. This is not just for Glenville. This is not just for Cleveland. It's for every inner city school in the entire country. We're representing that. No matter what you say, whatever you say out your mouth, it don't matter. I hear it all the time. I hear all the negative comments about our children. I hear all the negative comments about our school system. I hear all the negative comments about the great teams, the great coaches, the great programs that's not here in Cleveland, in the city of Cleveland, in the Glenville area. I hear all that. And parents, I hear you too. We are so negative to ourselves that we're looking at everybody else and forget about ourselves. We are the greatest people in America, right here in Cleveland, Ohio, in the inner city of Cleveland. Now, if you can't give yourself a round of applause for that, I don't know. I'm going to always walk with my head up for my children. I already know what we have to deal with. Y'all don't have a clue. But all those programs, all those private schools, all those, the best school in the state of Ohio, all the coaching, all that, all of the say what you not, where they at? Where they at? Where they at? Where they at? And we're going to continue after tomorrow when we win. You're going to still hear the same thing, and I'm going to ask you the same thing. Where they at? It's real disrespectful to tell somebody and some children that's been in the game for 50 years that you can't coach. You're unorganized. You're not disciplined. You're cheating. When you're winning, you're cheating because we're African Americans. We lack of discipline. They hard-headed. They don't know nothing. But where everybody at? Where they at? Don't talk like that. Don't talk like that. I've been dealing with it. My kids are dealing with it. We got to fight to keep the noise out. I'm gonna tell y'all this. Sandusky Perkins called yesterday, wanna play a game. Now, I've been in the game for almost 50 years. I've never seen the most disrespectful program in my life. And I'm telling y'all, man, nobody plays the team that's in your region. That showed the arrogance of that program. They think we're not who you think we are. But that's the type of stuff that we deal with. Because we're not hoodlums. We're a professional high school football team. No matter what anybody else says, no matter whatever is on your mind, no matter how negative you think of us, I'm gonna leave y'all with this. Where everybody at? Thank you.
Hello, 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 hello. Hello, 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 hello. First and foremost, you have been an awesome audience. Give yourselves a round of applause. We're not supposed to be in here this orderly. This is a great sight. This is a wonderful situation. And I really appreciate you understanding that this was an educational process today. Not only did you learn how to listen, not only did you learn how to pay attention, but you listen with your eyes, you listen with your body. And many of you have done an awesome job. Some of you need a little improvement, and we'll get there. But the bottom line is, overall, you all did a wonderful job. Where they at? So at this point, we're going to bring this to a close. It's been an awesome time, but the time has been far spent.
This is a story of famous dog. For the dog that chases its tail will be busy. These are clapping dogs, rhythmic dogs, harmonic dogs, house dogs, street dogs, dogs of the world unite, dancing dogs. Yeah, counting dogs, funky dogs, nasty dogs.
Don't take me turning, so keep it right there. My adrenaline is pumping right, stomach muscles getting tight, skin so wet, my fingers slide. I'll take you to a place you ain't never been. Again and again, won't you love me, baby? Ooh, I'm about to handle my business things. Make sure you handle me too. Close my eyes, let go of your. I just want more. I can't get enough. I can't get enough. It's out of doors. I just want more. I can't get enough of you. Close my door, let go of your. I just want more. I can't get enough of you. Let out of the door. It's out of doors. I just want more. Cause I can't get enough of you. Baby, who's gonna be pushing me around? I know you're losing after the second round. Then the consequence, maybe, that you have to switch to third round and make me scream like when I move it down. Put on a little show to let your baby know, but then I should be screaming uncontrollably. Hope you're ready to stay up one time, cause nothing's too much, baby, just what I want, baby. Close the door, close the door. I want
Hello, 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 hello. You have about 5 seconds to get back to your seat. 4, 3, 2, and. I still know how to do this. And Phil, sit down. You too, red coat. Down. Ms. Davis, English teacher, please see Ms. Parker. Ms. Davis, English teacher, is right behind you. Whenever you're quiet, I'll let you know what the next move is. Won't wait long, won't wait long, won't wait long. Thank you so much. What an awesome opportunity to not just party, but prepare to go do some things that will challenge our minds, our bodies, and our spirits. It's a wonderful time to gather for the right reasons. And that's what we have done today, and God is pleased. So here we need to understand that in every situation, some of you teachers need to know that in every good lesson plan, there is a culminating activity. So at the end of this and at the end of every morning session, we set it off right. We have a leader who is a senior, who has been put through some situations, who has been battle tested. That's why none of the younger people can do this. This young man can carry the rock, but his character is far greater than any athletic talent that you'll ever see him display on the field. One said, do not let your talent get you somewhere where your character can't keep you. This man has athletic ability, and his character is going to give you so much pride and joy
once he puts it on the big stage. So I'm bringing to the middle to lead the alma mater and the creed, the best running back in the state.
And like a superstar, superstar. They say I need to slow down when driving my fancy car, driving my fancy car. See, I know why you're mad at me. I'm getting more money than you, getting more money than you. Everybody knows why you do what you do. It's 'cause I'm getting more money than you, getting more money than you. They say they lose their appetite when I always front the bill. But baby, there's no need to lie, 'cause I know how you really feel.
Everybody up. Bryce West, at the end of the month, will be leaving Ginn Academy, going to The Ohio State University. Give him a hand. So I think he was playing in the All-Star game, but I think that's canceled, right?
Yeah, okay. So when you get young people that, first of all, graduate, you winning. But when you get them in college, you're dominating. So, Bryce, we appreciate the time you've been here, and we wish you all the luck on your career and your educational process at Ohio State. Give him another hand. So these next three guys, they're not leaving early, but they have accomplished something that you're going to see in another week or so. Fred, Toe, and Deshante will be on national TV playing the U.S. Army All-American game. So once again, I'm going to say this. Well, first of all, y'all know my thing is, if God ain't in it, you can't win it. God been in this for a long time. And we're going to keep our hands in God's hand because he got all power to make it happen. But what's important in this situation, the reason why I brought these guys up and those three guys, check the state of Ohio and see how many kids is playing the U.S. Army All-American game. Check it. They go all over the country to pick these players for the team. But we got three kids out of one school. So I wanted to let y'all know that because it's a big deal. When you talk about picking children out of the entire country, and you got three out of state of Ohio, out of one school, and just happened to be Glenville. So my last thing to you all again, where everybody is at. God bless you.